Hey guys, welcome to this tutorial where we'll be creating a cool glitch effect in Affinity Photo. Open the image in Affinity Photo. Go to the Layers tab and unlock the original image if locked by default. Rename the original image. Create a duplicate of the image by pressing Ctrl+J and rename it to Copy. With the Copy layer selected, open the Channels tab and click on Composite Red to view only the red channel. For the next step, we need the Shear tool. It is hidden by default. We need to add it to the tools on the left side. To achieve this, click on View, and then click on Customize Tools. Now you can access the Tools Customization tab, where all tool icons are displayed. To locate the Shear tool icon, please navigate to the 8th row and 6th column. Simply drag and drop the Shear tool icon to the end of the left side tool menu. Once you have done that, you can now close the Customization tab. Using the Shear tool, we will move the color channels in the left and right direction. Now click on the Shear tool. You can now see a new tab with two graphs with straight lines. Drag the top node of the vertical line to the right a little bit. It will move the lower portion of the red channel to the right. Then click on Apply. Next, click on the Composite Green on the Channels tab. Then open the Shear tab by clicking on the icon on the Tools menu. Now drag the top node of the vertical line to the left a little bit. It will move the lower portion of the green channel to the left. Then click on Apply. After displacing the channels, reset the channels to view the changes we made. I will close this channels panel because it is not needed. Before going into the next step, create a duplicate of this copy layer and rename it to Copy Glitch, then hide the copy layer. Click on the Rectangle Marquee tool. Change the mode to Add and then select a bunch of rectangles with a small breadth on the image at random. After selection, change the tool to Move tool. Now, holding the Shift key, move these selections to the right using the mouse or the right arrow button on the keypad. Then press Ctrl+D to deselect the rectangles. Again, using the same Rectangle Marquee tool, select a bunch of rectangles with very narrow breadth at random. Then move them to the left side and then deselect all. At this point, the basic parts of creating the glitch effect are finished. In the next steps, we will add some filters, adjustments, and layer effects, and finally add an overlay to make it more glitchy. For filters, we will add some live noise filters. Keep the noise intensity around 15% and the opacity of the noise filter around 75%. Next, we will add some levels of adjustment. In the Adjustment tab, keep the black level at around 15%, the white level at around 70%, and increase the gamma value slightly if necessary. Reduce the opacity of levels adjustment to around 65%. Next, add a gradient map. In the Gradient Map tab, change the colors according to your wish. I will stick with the default red, green, and blue colors. Add noises to the start and end colors. Change the blend mode to darken and reduce the opacity to around 15%. I will decrease the noise intensity of the noise filter to 10%. If we zoom in on the image, you can see these red and green lines on the sides of the image. This is because we displaced the red and green channels of the image. Let's remove it by cropping these ugly edges from the image. Click on the Crop tool. Change mode to Unconstrained. Holding the Control key, crop from the left or right side. Then click on Apply. Next, apply a color overlay to our image. Change the color to blue and reduce the opacity to around 10%. Let's add a glitch texture overlay to our image. I will place this glitch texture downloaded from FreePick on the canvas. Then position it according to our image. Change the blend mode to screen and reduce opacity to around 65%. Finally, add a brightness and contrast adjustment on the top of all layers. Increase the contrast and decrease the brightness slightly. For this image, I will increase the opacity of the blue overlay to around 15%. So, there you have it. With some channel manipulation, filters, and textures, we've created a trippy glitch effect. If you like this video, smash that like button, and don't forget to subscribe for more awesome tutorials.